Now we move to the reaction of chlorine with hot concentrated alkali. As usual, the same three reactions as in the reaction of chlorine with dilute alkali. First reaction, Cl2 plus H2O, it gives us HCl plus HOCl into 3 because we are taking hot concentrated alkali. So we have to multiply with 3. Overall, all the reactions, three reactions, we have to multiply it with 3. Second reaction is HCl plus NaOH, we are getting NaCl plus H2O. Third one, HOCl plus NaOH, it gives us NaOCl plus H2O into 3. Here, in the third reaction, we got NaOCl. So overall, into 3, we are getting 3 NaOCl. It again react and we are getting NaClO3 plus 2 NaCl. This is difference in compared to dilute alkali. Here this is a only difference. 3 NaOCl, it gives us NaClO3 plus 2 NaCl. While calculating in right overall reaction, we have to consider this reaction also, the fourth reaction also. 3 NaOCl, it gives us NaClO3 plus 2 NaCl. Let us calculate the overall reaction, children. First, Cl2, there is nothing cancelled. So, 3 Cl2 we can carry over. As usual, H2O, it got cancelled. And HCl also, it cancelled. HOCl also cancelled. In the case of water molecule, first reaction we have 3H2O. Second and third reaction we have 3H2O. So one of the 3H2O in getting cancelled. There is remaining 3H2O in the product side. Then in the case of NaOH, the second reaction we have 3 NaOH, third reaction we have 3 NaOH. So overall we have 6 NaOH. Then we move to the product side. Already I said the NaOCl. While calculating the overall reaction, the NaOCl reaction also we have to consider. Instead of 3 NaOCl, we have to write NaClO3 plus 2 NaCl. So what may be the product? NaClO3 plus 5 NaCl. How? NaCl in second reaction we have 3 and in the fourth reaction we have 2. So totally 5 NaCl plus 3H2O. Already we discussed 3 of the H2O is cancelled by the reactant side in first reaction. So what may be the overall reaction? 3Cl2 plus 6 NaOH, it gives us NaClO3 plus 5 NaCl plus 3H2O. Oxidizing and bleaching action of chlorine. Oxidizing and bleaching action of chlorine. We know chlorine is a strong oxidizing and bleaching agent because of the nascent oxygen. As it liberates nascent oxygen, so it reacts as a strong oxidizing and bleaching agent. First we see the reaction of chlorine with water. H2O plus Cl2, we are getting HCl plus HOCl. Hypochlorous acid. Hypochlorous acid, the formula is HOCl. Then this HOCl, that is hypochlorous acid, again we are getting HCl plus O. This O, the single oxygen atom. This is named as Nansen oxygen. Then the overall common reaction is coloring matter plus this oxygen, we are getting colorless oxidation product. Colored matter, it become colorless oxidation product and because of this Nansen oxygen. Here the bleaching of chlorine is permanent. I hope you remember sulfur dioxide bleaching action is temporary one, but here the bleaching of chlorine is permanent. We know chlorine oxidizes ferrous salt to ferric. The reaction is 2FeCl2 plus Cl2, it gives us 2FeCl3. 2FeCl3. FeCl2 it become FeCl3. Ferrous salt become ferric salt. Then we move to the example sulfides to sulfates, sulfides to sulfates. Here we are taking ferrous sulfate and it convert to ferric sulfate. FeSO4 convert to Fe2SO4 thrice. Here first reaction is Cl2 plus H2O, it gives us HCl plus HOCl. HCl plus HOCl. Second reaction is 2FeSO4 plus H2SO4 plus HOCl, it gives us Fe2SO4 thrice plus HCl plus H2O. Now we balancing the both equation and we have to write the overall reaction. Let us two children. Yes, there is no cancellation of FeSO4, so we can carry over. In sulfuric acid there is no cancellation. Cl2, it also not cancelled. But in water molecule, the second reaction is water molecule in product side. In first reaction, water molecule in reactant side. So both we are cancelling. So what may be the overall reaction reactant? 2FeSO4 plus H2SO4 plus Cl2. Then we move to the product side. Fe2SO4 thrice. It is not cancelled, so we can carry over. First reaction we have one HCl, second reaction we have one more HCl, so 2HCl. In the case of HOCl, it cancelled by second reaction. HOCl in product side of first reaction is cancelled by HOCl of reaction side in reaction 2. So what is the remaining? Fe2SO4 thrice plus 2HCl. So what is the overall reaction? 2FeSO4 plus H2SO4 plus Cl2, it gives us Fe2SO4 thrice plus 2HCl. Then we move to the Na2SO3, it become Na2SO4. One more example. Na2SO3 to Na2SO4. Sulfide to sulfate. Sodium sulfide to sodium sulfate. So as usual, first reaction Cl2 plus H2O, it gives us HCl plus HOCl. Second reaction Na2SO3 plus HOCl, it gives us Na2SO4 plus HCl. Now we are writing the overall reaction. Here only one cancellation, both HOCl, HOCl getting cancelled. So what is remaining? Na2SO3 plus H2O plus Cl2. The product side, Na2SO4 plus 2HCl, because one HCl in first reaction, one HCl in second reaction, both we are adding, we are getting 2HCl. So what is the overall reaction? Na2SO3 plus H2O plus Cl2, it gives us Na2SO4 plus 2HCl. Then we move to the hydrogen sulfide. The hydrogen sulfide, it become sulfur. Hydrogen sulfide, it become sulfur. Cl2 plus H2S, it gives us 2HCl plus S. We know preparation of bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is produced by passing chlorine gas through dry slaked lime. Slaked lime, we already know, calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice. Again repeat, bleaching powder is produced by passing chlorine gas through dry slaked lime. That is calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice. The chemical reaction is CaOH twice plus Cl2, it gives us CaOCl2 plus H2O. CaOCl2 is bleaching powder. Calcium oxychloride. Then displacement redox reaction. We hope redox is both oxidation and reduction take place. The chlorine displaces bromine from bromide and iodine from iodide. Here we are taking potassium bromide and potassium iodide. Here Cl2 plus 2KBr, it gives us 2KCl plus Br2. From KBr it become Br2. From Ki it become I2. Formation of addition compounds. Chlorine, it gives addition compounds. For example, chlorine combined with SO2, it gives sulfural chloride. And with carbon monoxide, it gives carbonyl chloride. Chlorine forms addition product with sulfur dioxide and carbon monoxide and ethylene. The chemical reactions are SO2 plus Cl2, it gives us SO2 Cl2 sulfuryl chloride, and CO plus Cl2, it gives us COCl2 carbonyl chloride. COCl2 is carbonyl chloride, and with ethylene C2H4 plus Cl2, it gives us C2H4Cl2 ethylene dichloride. And chlorine, it forms substituted product with alkanes and arenes. For example, CH4 plus Cl2, it gives us CH3Cl plus HCl aliphatic alkanes. It is a methane, so CH4 plus Cl2, it gives us CH3Cl plus HCl. And with the benzene arenes, CCH6 plus Cl2, it gives us CCH5Cl plus HCl chlorobenzene in the presence of FeCl3. Uses of chlorine. It is used in purification of drinking water and bleaching of cotton textiles, papers and rayon, and extraction of gold and platinum. Children, I hope you understood the concept. I request you to recall the concept what we learned today. Children, please try to answer the following questions. I give here 5 questions. Please try to do it. First question, give the balanced equation for the reaction between chlorine with cold sodium hydroxide and hot sodium hydroxide. Then how will you prepare chlorine in the laboratory? Third one, give the uses of sulfuric acid. Then fourth one, give a reaction to support that sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. Then try to complete the following reactions. First one, NaCl plus MnO2 plus H2SO4, it gives us what? Then second one, Cu plus hot concentrated sulfuric acid, it gives us what? Children, please kindly try to do the homework. Thank you.